Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Katie and I make weekly lifestyle and finance videos. And today I am showing you a little bit of a different video, which is my first trimester pregnancy haul. So I'm pregnant. Every time I say that out loud, I just can't believe it, even though I've definitely had a lot of time to process it. I'm currently in my second trimester, but every time I say it out loud, it still sounds weird because I can't believe it. But I wanted to do a video about everything I've bought so far in each trimester because I know pregnancy can be really expensive and there's so many must-have lists, and then you feel like you can buy everything and not end up using any of it. So I wanted to show you guys what I bought in my first trimester and the things that I actually used and how much I spent on it. So if you're interested in that video, keep watching. So I'm actually gonna make a second video all about like my first trimester experience and the must-have items, because a lot of the items I actually already had that I use in like my day-to-day life that is not necessarily aimed at pregnancy. So I just wanted to focus this video on just on items that I did buy and found really useful, but for the most part, in my first trimester, I actually didn't really buy much. I am really thankful I had a very easy first trimester, and given the state of the world in 2020, I really didn't have to invest in products that I might have had to buy if I was out and about more, or if I was going to work and might have thought about doing maternity products. So I hope that this video is useful. I understand that, you know, some of you, depending on your experience, will buy different items, but this is just the things that I needed to buy and what worked for me. So the first thing that I bought was prenatal vitamins. So this is really important, especially if you're someone that deals with nausea or sickness during your first trimester and you feel like your diet might be a little bit off. Case in point, I had a couple weeks where I was very sick, so I definitely was not eating salads and proteins. I was just eating good old white carbs. So prenatals are really important just to make sure you're still getting the amount of vitamins that you need during your pregnancy, but especially during the first trimester. So prenatal vitamins are really important because they contain folate or folic acid, which is really good at preventing birth defects in pregnancies. So I would highly recommend you guys making sure that you take a prenatal. I'll say as a disclaimer, there are so many prenatals on the market, so definitely do your research, consult with your friends and family and your doctor about which ones to take. I don't want to give you guys medical advice, so I'm not going to say the one that I took here, but I actually took a different prenatal and it made me very sick, so I had to switch the one I bought. So I bought prenatals. So far I've bought 2 packs of them. I've gone through almost 2 jars of them. Each pack was $12.49, and again, there's so many on the market, so do your research. I'm not going to specifically advise you guys to take one prenatal over the others, just ask your doctor what to take. So that is the very first thing that I bought when I found out I was pregnant. The second thing I bought was stretch mark creams, stretch mark prevention lotions and creams. I definitely bought those lotions and oils. I've been using them so far. I don't really know if they're doing anything because, to be honest, I'm only in my second trimester and I haven't really seen that much body changes in terms of my stomach getting larger. I'll say these lotions are not going to prevent you from getting stretch marks. It is genetic, so if your mother had stretch marks, it's very likely that you are going to get them. But I know that you can kind of get really itchy during your pregnancy, especially on your stomach, so it is a good habit to get into, of just getting in the process of like lotioning your stomach. Because I don't know about you guys, but when I used to get out of the shower, I mean, I would try to like lotion my whole body, but I don't really get a dry stomach, so I never was kind of conditioned to lotion my stomach. So just that process has been very odd. I have bought 2. They were $5.49 each. It is the Palmer's Cocoa Butter Formula Massage Lotion for stretch marks. I have no idea why I bought this one. Honestly, it had really good reviews online, and that's kind of why I bought it. I haven't honestly done too much research into what are the best like lotions and creams for stretch marks, just because I know that a lot of this is genetic, so I don't know how much this is gonna help, but I like the mental idea that this is helping. So I've bought 2 so far. Currently, I'm like halfway through the first one. It is really thick, so you don't need a lot, and I love the smell of this. It smells like cocoa butter, so if you do like that, you'll enjoy this. So I think I actually might use this moving forward just as like a moisturizer, because it's really moisturizing, and yeah, it doesn't irritate my skin because I have very sensitive skin, and this is great for that. The next thing I bought was this bile oil skincare oil for scars and stretch marks. It is the 4.2 fluid ounce bottle. It was $20, And I just bought this because I used this when I was growing up. So I had this really odd growth spurt when I was about 18 or 19. I'm pretty sure I grew like 2 inches in 6 months. So I definitely had a couple stretch marks and I found this really helpful. And this is obviously a fan favorite. Do I know if it does anything? I don't know. I haven't used it. You can see that this is full. I think I'm gonna try to save this when I get into my third trimester where I can see that my body's rapidly changing. So I bought this and we will see if it works. So I'm not really gonna talk about grocery expenses when it comes to pregnancy, just because, you know, that's an expense you have every week or every other week. And I don't necessarily think that just because I'm pregnant, I'm spending more money on groceries, but I just wanted to call out lemons because I had some intense sickness for a couple weeks and I was extremely nauseous. And for some reason for me, the only thing that made me feel better was ice cold lemon water. So I spent $10 on lemons. I went through so many lemons. Like, I had friends over for my birthday and they were like, oh, we want to bring you a gift. Like, you're pregnant, I can't bring you wine. What should we bring you? And I was like, lemons. And I'm pretty sure they thought I was kidding, but I was being dead serious. They helped me so much when I was experiencing some nausea. So if you experience that, maybe that will help you. I know, you know, remedies are very personal, but yeah, I bought a lot of lemons. That is everything I bought during my first trimester. This is the total because I can't do math in my head. And I know when you're watching this, you're like, Katie, you bought like 4 things, but honestly, I didn't feel like I needed much during my first trimester. I'm trying to be really conscious of what to spend on my pregnancy because it is, even though it's 10 months and it is a long period of time, I mean, it's almost a year plus, you know, your fourth trimester, as people call it, when you actually have like a newborn and your body's doing a lot of changes during that period. But in the wider scheme of things, pregnancy is such a short time in your life. And I don't want to kind of like go all out and buy all these products that I don't really use. I'm really trying to be frugal and conscious of what to buy. And during my first trimester, I had a pretty decent first trimester. I mean, I definitely experienced nausea, but I was working from home, so I didn't have to really buy any new clothing products. During my first trimester, I really didn't see that many body changes, so I didn't have to buy, you know, larger leggings or maternity leggings or comfier clothing. I have so many like oversized clothing, so I was just living in sweats in my day-to-day life during COVID-19, so me being pregnant during COVID-19 doesn't really change that much. So I didn't really buy that much, and a lot of the other products I already have, and I will do a whole other video on your pregnancy must-haves for your first trimester. But yeah, that's all the money I spent. I'm really happy about it. I don't think I went overboard. Watched a lot of videos about what you should spend while you're pregnant in your first trimester. And to be honest, a lot of the products, I just didn't really see a use for them, or for me particularly, they were not that applicable. So definitely if you're pregnant, I mean, take things like these videos with a grain of salt, really see what you're experiencing and what your symptoms are and what you will need during your first trimester. The reason why I didn't really spend that much money or buy that many things is because during your first trimester, and I don't wanna, you know, put any negativity out into the world, but the risk of miscarriage is still quite high. So it would be really bad if, although I definitely saw great deals on bassinets and car seats and stuff like that, for me to buy these things and then I miscarried pretty early on. That for me would be pretty devastating because I've already started like investing. So I definitely don't want to do any of that stuff till I'm past like the 20 week mark. It's just a personal opinion. That's just what I'm doing. Doesn't mean you have to do it at all, but that's part of the reason why I just didn't buy baby clothes or anything like that. So I'll definitely be doing that in my second trimester. So I want to continue doing this video so you guys see like an honest breakdown of the cost, because pregnancy can be very expensive. So I just want to be real with you guys and let you know how much I'll be spending. So yeah, if you enjoyed this video and want to see more pregnancy videos, let me know in the comments if you found this video interesting and what you're kind of interested in seeing. I know most of my videos are about finance, budgeting, frugal living, so this is like slightly different. I tried to include the finance part of it, which I hope you guys found was enjoyable. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Bye guys.